2-0 series lead. In game three, despite scoring three shorthanded goals, one of them, the first ever successful shorthanded penalty shot completed by Jordan Martinuk, would be enough, as the Devils would win by a score of 8-4. Game four started out the same way as game three for the Devils. Jack Hughes put New Jersey up 1-0 just 1:55 into the first period. Frederick Anderson made key saves to keep the Carolina Hurricanes within a goal until late in the period when Jacob Slavin makes a Slavin-esque type play, getting the puck to Jordan Martinuk, who had set up Marty Natchez to tie this game late in the first. The second period would belong to the Canes. Marty Natchez would bury a Brett Pesce pass and notch his second of the game to put Carolina on the 2-1, kicking off an outburst for the history books. Brett Pesce, Jesper Fox, and Brent Burns all got on the score sheet in a span of just under 4 minutes. The Hurricanes moved up. Jordan Martinuk continues to beat Devil New Jersey, scoring his third goal of the series and set a Canes record with his fourth consecutive multiple-point playoff game. From there, the Hurricanes would clamp down on the Devils in the third period and head back to Raleigh with a 3-1 series lead. The Canes have shown throughout this postseason what this team is made of. And no outside voices matter. But here, inside PNC Arena, there are voices that matter. Yours. Tonight isn't just another playoff game in Raleigh. Tonight is another chance to show the hockey world what Hurricanes playoff hockey is. Canes, are you ready to show why there is no better home ice advantage in the league? Are you ready to let your voices be heard? Game 5 is next.
Good evening, Canes, and welcome to PNC Arena, our loudest house in the NHL, where it's a great night for playoff hockey and rally. Tonight is round 2, game 5, featuring the visiting New Jersey Devils.
This team to write the story. This generation.
leadership, toughness, grit, style, leadership, flair, build. This team will never come home.